Glory to Jesus Christ.
Glory forever.
Слава Ісусу Христу.
Слава на віки.
Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, today we have 22nd Sunday after Pentecost. On this Sunday, we continue to pray for sick people in our community. We also continue to pray for peace in the whole world, especially for peace in Ukraine, Syria, Iraq, Azerbaijan, Armenia. And today we have special intention. We'll pray for the departed servant of God, Anna Holovaty. And I remind you and I remind myself that today also we celebrate the memory of Unmercenary physicians Cosmas, Damian, and also we celebrate the passing away from us to eternity, Metropolitan Andrey Sheptytsky in 1944, and also passing away of Bishop Martyr. He was beatified in Ukraine 2001, Theodore, Romzha. And today is Halloween, but we are in the church to celebrate the resurrection of our Lord. And today also we will have a nice opportunity to talk about how to avoid the nets of death. And we give the floor to our cantor, Mr. Mike, and he will lead us in the singing. Thank you.
Our opening hymn will be on page 960. I will ever tell your greatness, God, my Lord and King. I will bless your name forever.
Blessed be the kingdom of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and forever and ever.
Amen.
In peace let us pray to the Lord.
Lord have mercy.
For the peace, for life, for salvation, so let us pray to the Lord.
Lord have mercy.
For peace, for the world, for the world being God, for the church is visiting evil, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord have mercy.
For this holy church, for all and his faith, the reverend, the fear of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord have mercy.
From the universe, the Lord, the Francis Pope, the Rome, from the blessed Peter, Святой Самозы, Метропон Кербореса, Галамбиш, Киболдан, then peace with the King, the Echonite in Christ, and all the clergy, the people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord have mercy.
From Vishnu, God, from God, and from the military, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord have mercy.
For the city of peace, for every city, kind of, for the faithful, and them, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord have mercy.
For favor, by the abundance of the fruits of the earth, for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord have mercy.
For the sufferers, travelers, for the sick, the suffering, for the captive, for the salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord have mercy.
That we may be delivered from all tribulation, wrath, and misfortune, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord have mercy.
Help and save our mercy and protect us, O God, by your grace.
Lord have mercy.
In the most holy, make with us blessed and glorious Lady, the Mother of God, and ever Virgin Mary, the of all the saints. Let us commit ourselves, what it is, to light to Christ, O God. Beyond measure is love from mankind, and expression the kindness of your heart, O my soul, look upon us and upon this holy church, and peace on us, was praying with us the riches of your mercy and compassion. For glory, O Lord, worship befit you, O Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever and ever.
Psalm of the Typica, page 101. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and let all that is within me bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits. He forgives all your iniquities. He heals all your diseases. He redeems your life from corruption. He crowns you with mercy and compassion. Compassionate and merciful is the Lord. Long-suffering and abounding in mercy. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and let all that is within me bless his holy name. Blessed are you, O Lord. Page 105. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
Again in peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord have mercy.
Help and save mercy and protect us, O God, by your grace.
Lord have mercy.
Remember most holy, make with us blessed and glorious Lady, the Mother of God, and ever Mary, the guest of all the saints. Let us commit ourselves, as well as we light in Christ, our God.
To you, Lord.
For your good and loving God, we give glory to you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever and ever.
Amen. The Beatitudes, page 109. Remember us, O Lord, in your kingdom. Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the land. Blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the pure of heart, for they will see God. Blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when they insult you and persecute you, and utter every kind of evil word against you falsely because of me. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven.
Wisdom, be attentive.
Come, let us worship and fall down before Christ, Son of God, risen from the dead. Save us who sing to you, Alleluia. The Troparion in the fifth tone, page 345. Let us the faithful acclaim and worship the Word, co-eternal with the Father and the Spirit, and born of the Virgin for our salvation. For he will to be lifted up on the cross in the flesh to suffer death, and to raise the dead by his glorious resurrection. And to the Holy Spirit. You, my Savior, descended to Hades, and as the Almighty you shattered his gates. With yourself, you as the Creator raised the dead and shattered the sting of death, and delivered Adam from the curse, O lover of mankind. And so we cry out, to intercede for those who sing and worship the child you bore.
For your God, our Holy, we give glory to you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever and ever.
The Prokimenon in the fifth tone, page 348. You, O Lord, will guard us and will keep us from this generation and forever. Save me, O Lord, for there is no longer left a just man. You, O Lord, will guard us.
Epistle to the Galatians.
Let us be attentive,
brethren. See how large a letter I have written to you with my own hand. As many as desire to make a fair show in the flesh, they compel you to be circumcised, only that they may not be persecuted for the cross of Christ. For not even those who are circumcised do themselves keep the law, but they desire to have you circumcised, that they may boast in your flesh. But God forbid that I should boast, except in the cross of our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom the world is crucified to me, and I to the world. For in Christ Jesus neither circumcision counts for anything, nor uncircumcision, but a new creation. And as many as walk according to this rule, peace be upon them, and mercy and upon the Israel of God. Henceforth let no one trouble me, for I bear in my body the brand marks of the Lord Jesus. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with your spirit, brethren. Amen.
Peace be to you, reader, wisdom. Let us be attentive.
The Alleluia in the fifth tone, page 348. Alleluia. To generation, I will announce your truth with my mouth.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
For you have said, mercy shall be built up forever in the heavens, your truth shall be prepared.
Alleluia. Jesus, he cried out, fell down before him, and with a loud voice said, what have I to do with you, Jesus, Son of the Most High God? I beg you, do not torment me. For he had commanded the unclean spirit to come out of the man, for it had often seized him, and he was kept under guard, bound with chains and shackles, and he broke the bonds and was driven by the demon into the wilderness. Jesus asked him, saying, what is your name? And he said, Legion, because many demons had entered him, and they begged him that he would not command them to go out into the abyss. Now a herd of many swine was feeding there on the mountain, so they begged him that he would permit them to enter there, and he permitted them. Then the demons went out of the man and entered the swine, and the herd ran wildly down the steep place into the lake and drowned. When those who fed them saw what had happened, they fled and told it in the city and in the country. Then they went out to see what had happened and came to Jesus and found the man from whom the demons had departed, sitting at the feet of Jesus, clothed and in his right mind, and they were afraid. They also who had seen it told them by what means he who had been demon-possessed was healed. Then the whole multitude of the surrounding region of the Gadarenes asked him to depart from them, for they were seized with great fear, and he got into the boat and returned. Now the man from whom the demons had departed begged him that he might be with him. But Jesus sent him away, saying, return to your own house and tell what great things God has done for you. And he went his way and proclaimed throughout the whole city what great things Jesus had done for him. Той час пришел Иисус в синагогу, щоб проводити, як Ісус вийшов. Вийшов наперед, попався йому на суді один чоловік з міста, що мав бісів. Він знав його час і носив одежі, мешкав не в хаті, а в ромах. Побачивши Ісуса, він закричав, припав йому до ніг і сказав сильним голосом, що мені тобі, Ісусе, Сину Бога Всевишнього, благаю тебе, не муч мене. Він повелів нечистому духові вийти з чоловіка. Дух той часто хапав чоловіка його, тоді в'язали кайданами та ланцюгами і стерегли. Та він трошив окови, і демон гонив його по пустинях. Ісус питав його, як тобі на ім'я? Легіон відповів той, багато побісів ішли в нього, і вони благали його, щоб він не велів їм іти в безодню. Було ж там велике стадо свиней, що паслися на горі, і демони просили його, щоб він дозволив їм увійти в них. Він дозволив їм. Вийшли демони з чоловіка, вийшли в свиней, кинулися стадо, скручив озеро і потонуло. Побачивши, що сталося, пастухи кинулись у розтіч і розповіли про це в місті та по селах. І вийшли люди подивитися, що сталося. Прибули вони до Ісуса і знайшли чоловік, з якого вийшли біси, сидів при ногах Ісуса, одягнений та при обій злякались. Наочні ж свідки їм розповіли, як вилікувався віснувати. Тоді все населення Герасимської округи почало його просити, щоб він відійшов від них, бо великий страх огорнув їх, і він увійшов до човна і вернувся. А чоловік, з якого вийшли біси, просив Ісуса, щоб бути з ним, але він відпустив його, кажучи, вернися додому і скажи все, що Бог зробив тобі. Пішов той, сповіщаючи по всьому місті, що Ісус зробив йому. The Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Glory to Jesus Christ. Слава Ісусу Христу! I start my homily today from example. So I tell you that last week I had a great conversation with my friend. We became friends just 2-3 years ago. He's not Catholic, he's not Ukrainian, he's not even my age. He's like 65, close to 70. But we had to do good things last week, and we draw to help one old lady, you know, to move some stuff in your house. And we had this conversation. He told me about his life. And when he was young, some kind of terrible thing happened to him. He was 16. At this age, he decided to leave the house because he didn't like his family. Dad was alcoholic, mama, she was busy with
other children, you know, because brother and sister all together, they were like 12 children in the family. So he decided to leave the house, to leave the family, and he lived for a couple months behind Walmart in the basement of the churches. And on the end, I asked him, because I read the gospel for today, you know, did you decide to live among tombstones like this man, you know, from today's gospel? He said, no, because my imagination didn't reach that point, you know. So I said, you did well, because to live at the cemetery, you know, you always have this, you're afraid, you know, because during the night, somebody can come, you know, and can afraid you more. So in the end, he said that he learned a lot in his life, but he tried to do good things. He had this good intention to help people. And sometimes people don't answer nicely to him. For example, he's a good mechanic, you know, he can fix the car. And sometimes he said that I stopped to help people, you know. They pulled out the car on the road, you know. I stopped my car, you know, and I asked him, do you want that they help you? No, no, go away, you know. What do you want from us? Do you want money from us? He said, no, I don't want money. I just like to help. I like to help people. So on the end, he said, I learned one thing. Doesn't matter what people think about you, you have to do good things to them. So now, we are in the 21st century, and I tell you one thing, 18th century is very bad century, because civilization in Europe, especially with French Revolution, they decided to cancel God. We don't need God. He doesn't help us. So, if God doesn't help us, that means that we have not to search for the truth, because God is truth. But we forgot one thing. That here's the man, you know. Truth is here, inside of us. God is here. Doesn't matter what we do, but there is truth in us. So today, when we heard about possessed man by demons, we said to ourselves, wow, Legion, the name of these demons. Legion means 6,000 demons inside of one man. And that man is possessed completely by demons. So how to help this poor man? Lord Jesus Christ, he's Lord. He can do everything. But now, how we can help ourselves? So we keep in mind that demon, ugly demon, yeah, he is master of lie. He likes to lie because this is his nature. He lied to us, he lied to himself, he lies to God. So, what's happened? Why he entered into person? How we allow to him to enter into us? Because we don't pay attention to one thing. We can lie to others, but the most dangerous lie when we start to lie to ourselves. when you lie to yourself, you do very bad thing. And now I will try to explain to you why this is a bad thing. Because this is not psychology, lesson of from psychology, but we have four types of lies to yourself. Four types. First type is outright lie. This is conscious distortion of reality by thoughts and words. Person trying to follow himself in operational matters. So we distort the reality, first point. We say that reality is this, even that reality doesn't correspond to the truth. Second lie. Lie of default. Where a person approaches a fence inside of himself. So I said that true in us. And there are little fence. That fence, our heart. Let us think about our heart. Protect, that fence protect the truth inside of us. Instead, to go inside of that, of our hearts, you know, that territory, we avoid that. Because we don't like that true inside of us will help us, for example, to clarify my internal conflict. What's wrong with me? I don't like to change my life because I dumped to myself. It's too late. I don't like to rebuild again my life. I prefer to go in the same way, you know, the same way. So, default. Lie of default. And third lie, we call this lie of ignorance. Lie of ignorance. What does that mean? Lie of ignorance, where a person does even realize that there is reserved kingdom within himself. It's like blind spot. Blind spot. And in that kingdom, we have unfulfilled talents, unfulfilled mission of life, unfulfilled promises to ourselves. And we have also, in that kingdom, main fears. And that main fears can destroy us. And we prefer to ignore that kingdom in us. And we come to the fourth lie. This is worst lie. That lie means that lie of intention or intense direction of mind, words and thoughts and our attention. And we don't know how to learn to use this intention in our life. So all these lies that we say to ourselves destroys our humanity, destroy us. And then, now we learn why demon so easy can possess us? Because we allow to him to enter into us. We allow to him to be in us, to chain us, to break us into pieces. And we allow to him to touch us, even inside. Let us think, we are this submarine, you know. To survive underwater, submarine constantly send these sounds in different directions, yeah? There. And in the main office of a submarine, you know, there are no, they never stop, you know, to send these sounds, you know, because they have to navigate. Even during the night, they don't sleep. We think that when we sleep, you know, everything is shut down. No, our mind continue to send sounds and receive back information. But what kind of information we receive? We receive everything. But the main problem that we, if we don't learn how to use this intention, intense, or our attention, and send that sound directly to God, we become prey of this predator. He will catch us and he will keep us in his nets. He cannot kill us, but his nature to devour us step by step, because this is his nature. And when we don't learn how to escape this evil spirit, we will not learn how to save ourselves. So every time in the morning, when we start, we wake up, and we send first sound, our prayer. Lord, thank you for giving of life. This is like we start to live, because we remind ourselves about our Creator, you know. And we like submarine, we try to move in underwater, and there are a lot of mistakes. We can crash against big stone, we can crash against another submarine, you know, but we have information. That information comes to us. It's very important not to ignore that information, not to avoid the truth, and not to distort by our thoughts and words the reality that around us. So today, the message of the gospel, be careful. Be attentive, because he would like to devour you, he would like to possess you. But if you keep your eyes on me, on God, I will not only save you, but you will be able to go through all these obstacles, problems, tragedies, and gray color that dominate in your life and decisions. This is what today's gospel tells us. And very beautiful thing we learn from today's gospel. Remember your name, who you are. If you forget who you are, you know, if you forget that you are God's child, you're done. And then, if you remember what's your name, if you have this great desire to follow your Lord, you know, everything will be okay. So this is our Christian life. Even we try to do good things to people and we have no thank you for them, you know, we have to continue to do good things because this is our intention. This is our attention that we pay to our neighbors and we pay to God. We remind ourselves about our kingdom in us. We remind ourselves about our truth in us, you know. And we remind ourselves that we never have to distort the reality. Few things in today's gospel, but very powerful things. Because our life depends from them. Because our life depends from our name. Our life depends how what we do in our life, you know, and how we try to find the truth in our life. Because reality, it's life with our Lord, with God. This is reality. Because God is real. And demon, he's fake. Because he has no life in himself. He has no life in himself. He only exists. But we can live. We can live because we connect ourselves to God. Thank you for your attention. And I think that next Sunday we will continue to find out, you know, how to save our soul in this world. In the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Amen. Glory to Jesus Christ.
Let us all save his own soul, and might let us say,
Lord, have mercy.
Almighty Lord, God, Father, as we pray, you hear us, and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Have mercy on us, O God, in the greatness of your compassion, we pray, you hear us, and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
We also pray for most holy universal Pontiff Francis, Pope of Rome, from us, blessed be the Chief of Slava, Mother, and for those who serve and serve the Holy Church, for our spiritual fathers and for our brethren in Christ.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
We also pray for the nation of God, for our government, for the military.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
We also pray that the Lord our God would grant that the faithful servant of God, Metropolitan Andrey Sheptytsky, together with all our churches, holy martyrs, and confessors of faith in Christ, be numbered among the saints and glorified with them through their beatification and canonization.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
O physician of souls and bodies in harm, prepare hearts before you. Heal every sickness and pressure afflict your servants, Catherine, Irene, Francis, Sophia, Vera, Miriam, Justin, Ruth, Daria, Lori,
Priscilla, the young Donald Basil, forgive them every transgression, whether voluntary or involuntary. In the goodness of your heart, quickly raise them from the beds of illness. We beg you, Lord, hear us and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
We also pray for the people here present, the way to create the wonderful mercies for those being kind to us and for Lord to those Christians. Spirit and love it forever and ever.
Amen.
Again and again, in the peace of the faithful, pray to the Lord.
Lord. All the priests and the religious orders, our nation, all the military, the noble, ever to be remembered, founders, benefactors of this holy church, and may God remember his kingdom, departed servant of God, Anna, and all you, Orthodox Christians, always now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen.
Христа. Also the petition of us sinners, then bring them to your holy altar. Enable us to offer gifts and spirit sacrifice for our sins, for the sins of ignorance of the people. Make us worthy to find favor with you, that their sacrifices may be acceptable to you, so that the good spirit of your grace may rest upon us, upon these gifts present before us, and upon all your people.
Through the mercy of your name, God, the Son, is whom blessed, together with your most holy, good, God-given spirit, now and forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace be with all. In confessing
the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, the Trinity, one in being and undivided.
The doors in wisdom, let us be attentive.
I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, life from life, true God from true God, begotten, not made, one in being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit he was born of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered, died, and was buried. On the third day he rose again in fulfillment of the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come.
Let us stand, well, let us stand with you, let us be attentive to offer the holy oblation.
Of mercy, of peace, the sacrifice of praise.
The grace of Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, the Father, the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
Let us lift up our hearts.
We have lifted them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord.
It is right. To worship the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, the Trinity, one in being and undivided.
Angel, the cherubim, the seraphim, the sweet many eyed, hovering aloft on their wings.
Sidi, crying, exclaiming, and saying, the triumph of him.
Holy, holy, holy Lord of Sabaoth, heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the
With this blessed power of my soul, amen, we do cry up and say, Holy are you, truly all holy, union of God's Son and your Holy Spirit. Holy are you, truly all holy, manifested is your glory. You so love the world of all as to give you only begotten Son, that there is in him and on flesh by my eternal life. After he had come and fulfilled the whole one plan for our sake, on the night he was given over to him himself to the life of the world, he took breath into his holy spirit as he made with his hands and gave thanks. Blessed, sanctified, broken, gave us. What did the disciples apostles say? Take it, this is my body which is broken for you, for the forgiveness of sins. Supper saying, drink of it, all of you, this is my blood of the new covenant, which is poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Remember therefore this sacred commandment and all that was done for us, the cross, the tomb, the resurrection, the third day, the ascension to heaven, the sitting right hand, and the second glory is coming. We offer to you yours of your in behalf of all and for all. And in bloody worship, and we ask and we pray and we entreat you. Send down your Holy Spirit upon us, upon these gifts here present, and make this bread the precious body of your Christ.
Amen.
And that which in this church is the precious blood of your Christ.
Amen.
Changing them by your Holy Spirit.
Amen.
So that they may be for the communion, right of soul, forgiveness of sin, fellowship of your Holy Spirit, fulfilling the kingdom of heaven, confidence before and for judgment and condemnation. For the offer of this rational worship, for those who have gone through the rest in faith, for fathers, patriarchs, prophets, apostles, teachers, ministers, martyrs, confessors, ascetics, for every righteous soul that finished this life in faith, especially from us holy, the most blessed and glorious Lady, the Mother of God, and ever Virgin Mary. For the sake of your holy churches, grant that they may live in peace, safety, honor, and health for many years, and right in part of it be true. Remember, O Lord, the city of peace in which we live, and every city and country the faithful live in them. Remember, O Lord, the seekers and travelers, the sick and the suffering, the Lord have kept in thy salvation. Remember, O Lord, those who bear fruit in good works in holy churches, and remember the poor. Send down your mercy upon all of us, and grant that with one voice, one heart, we may glorify and sing the praises of your master, honor, magnificent name, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever and ever.
Amen.
And may the mercy of our great God and Savior Jesus Christ be with all of you. Again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord have mercy.
For the precious gift which I presented and consecrated, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord have mercy.
That our life God has received them, spirit of forgiveness upon his holy heaven, and his altar may send down upon us in the divine grace and the gift of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray.
Lord have mercy.
That he may be delivered from all tribulation, wrath, and misfortune, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord have mercy.
As we ask, we pray and intercede, you make us worthy to partake with the pure conscience of the awesome heavenly mystery, the sweet spirit of the table, for forgiveness of sins, for the pardon of offense, for fellowship of the Holy Spirit, for the inheritance of the kingdom of heaven, for confidence before and not for judgment and condemnation. Help us, have mercy, protect us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
That this whole day may be perfect, God, if it's sin, let us ask the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
For him, peace, faith, with God, God, souls, and bodies, let us ask the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
For the forgiveness, remission of sins, offense, let us ask the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
For all that is good, beneficial for our souls, for peace, for the world, let us ask the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
That you may spend the rest of our lives in peace and repentance, let us ask the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
For Christian and our lives, while the death is painless, unashamed, and peaceful, for good defense, let us ask the Lord. Grant this, O
Lord.
The faith for the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, let us come at ourselves one and to light to Christ our God.
To you, O Lord.
And make us worthy your master with confidence and with our condemnation, I call you the heavenly God, Father, and say,
our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth. Our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, Father, the Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace be with us all.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads to the power, your creative things in the great mercy, brought all things will not see to win. Look down from heaven, Master, upon those who bow their heads to you, for they have not bowed them down to flesh and blood, but to you, the awesome God. Therefore, Master, may smooth the way of life before us all for our good, according with each one's personal need. Save his sufferers, travelers, travelers, heal the sick, of physicians, souls, and lives. Through the grace of the loving Christ, your only begotten Son, of you blessed to give your most holy good, like in spirit, now and forever and ever.
Amen.
Eternal Lord Jesus Christ of God, from the holy dwelling, from the throne of glory, in your kingdom come to sanctify us. You are sitting now with the Father, and represent him with us. Deign to give to us with your mighty hand, your most pure life, your precious blood, and trust to all the people. God, be merciful to me, a sinner. God, be merciful to me, a sinner. God, be merciful to me, a sinner.
Let us be attentive to all the things for the holy.
One is holy. To the glory of God the Father. Amen. Praise the Lord from the heavens. Praise him in the highest. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
I believe, O Lord, and confess that you are truly Christ, the Son of the living God, who came into the world to save sinners, of whom I am first. Accept me this day, Son of God, as a partaker of your mystical supper. I will not tell the mystery to your enemies, nor will I give you a kiss as did Judas, but like the thief I confess you. Remember me, O Lord, when you come in your kingdom. Remember me, O Master, when you come in your kingdom. Remember me, O Holy One, when you come in your kingdom. May the partaking of your holy mysteries, O Lord, be unto me not for judgment or condemnation, but for the healing of soul and body. God, be merciful to me, a sinner. God, cleanse me of my sins and have mercy on me. I have sinned without number. Forgive me, O Lord. Extra communion verses can be found on page 1080. Praise him, all his angels. Praise him, all his hosts. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Praise him, sun and moon. Praise him, stars and lights. Alleluia, alleluia.
Approach with the fear, O God, with faith and with love.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. God the Lord has appeared to us.
Just one person.
Constantly in my mouth. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. My soul shall glory in the Lord. Let me hear and rejoice.
It is the one who hopes in him.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. This is touch your lips, remove your weaknesses and future sins. Save your people, Lord, and bless you. With joy and gladness always, now and forever and ever. Amen. Be excelled, O God, above the heavens, above all the earth. Be your glory. Blessed is our God. Always, now and forever and ever.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Stand right here and receive the divine, holy, immaculate, immortal, heavenly, given us through Christ. Let us rightly give thanks to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help and save mercy and protect us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Command that this whole day may be perfect, holy, peaceful, sinless. Let us commit ourselves to one and us to light the Christ, the God.
To you, O Lord.
Thank you, as a love, man can perfect our soul, that even today you have made us worthy of your heavenly immortal mysteries. May Israel's path make us all feel and fear you. Protect our lives, hero steps through the prayers and supplications of the glorious Mother of God and ever Virgin Mary and of all your saints. For you are our sanctification, we give glory to you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us go forth in peace.
In the name of the Lord.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
You bless those who bless you, O Lord, and sanctify those who trust in you. Save your people and bless your inheritance. Protect the fullness of your church. Sanctify those who love the beauty of your house and glorify them by your divine power. Do not forsake us who hope in you. Grant peace to you, all your churches, to the priests of the nation, and God to our government, and to all your people. For all good giving and every perfect gift is from above, coming down from you, the Father of lights, and we give glory to you. Glory, thanks, and worship to you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever and ever.
Amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord, now and forever, now and forever. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
The blessing of the Lord be upon you with his grace and love for mankind, always now and forever and ever.
Amen.
Glory be to you, Christ our God, our hope. Glory be to you.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever and ever. Amen. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Give the blessing.
Christ our true God, risen from the dead through the praise of his immaculate mother, of our holy, glorious prophet, for I am baptized of the Lord John, of all praiseworthy apostles, of our Father among the saints, John, Bishop Constantinople, of the holy Wonderworkers and Unmercenaries, Cosmas, Damian, his beatitude of righteous Father, Andrey, Sheptytsky, Metropolitan, and Archbishop V, whose blessing to eternal life we commemorate on this day, and through the prayers of all the saints, Christ will have mercy and save us, for his good loves mankind. Glory to Jesus Christ. Slava Jesus Christu. Dear brothers and sisters, thank you again for your coming to the church on this day. And also thank you for your cooperation, because last week again we made good profit from Peroia, and also we continue to buy few things, because we need more refrigerators, more freezers. So we buy the last week freezer, yeah, for the church. And also we come close to that point that finally we will have a special certificate of how do they call in English, occupancy for that apartment on East Carson Street 7-7. And also we had already a few people who came and saw that apartment, you know, so we hope that pretty soon we will have people who will live over there and will give us a little profit, you know, for that apartment. And on this day, yeah, we commemorate pass into eternal life of great Metropolitan Andrey Sheptytsky, and also we commemorate on this day passing away of Bishop, Martyr, and Professor of Faith Theodore Romzha. He is the bishop from Mukachevo, and he was leader of Ruthenian church in 20 centuries, and he was beatified together with all Ukrainians blessed fathers and mothers by Pope John Paul II in Lviv 2001. And today we commemorate his passing away. And also in today's bulletin you can find this nice story about Ukrainian mothers, written by Father Romanos Russo. This father reminds us about this great Metropolitan, but also reminds us how to be faithful to God, you know, to the end. Because Metropolitan Andrey Sheptytsky, he is not only surprised his family, because when he changed the ride, when he changed, you know, he did mission in his life. He decided to be Ukrainian. For that reason, he was hated by all Poles, you know, Polish Church and also Roman Catholics at his time. And also, he tried to make these bridges between Catholic Church and Orthodox Church. Even he was in the prison in Suzdal in Rostov, you know. He had a lot of friends among Orthodox priests and bishops. And he became not only modest for us, but also he became the spiritual leader. And now they open a great museum last week in Lviv. And in that museum, you can find also little details about his efforts, you know, how he dedicated even his own money to help the church. You have to think that at his time he was a very rich man, but he invested in orphanages, in hospitals, more than $2 million of his own money. He was monk, he was count, he was Christian, but he gave himself to the church. This is a great example how we have lived our life, what we have to do in our life. $2 million just to help orphans and sick people in the hospitals. And I remind you that again we continue to pray for all victims of COVID-19, because now we are focusing on the election, but also the number of sick people, they raise a little bit even in the United States. But let us pray for each other, you know, and at the same time let us keep distance, social distance, and protect each other, you know, from this virus. In the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Amen. Glory to Jesus Christ.
Glory to Christ. Our closing hymn will be on page 1016, 1016. We'll do the first two verses. Render praise.